Okay, well, Mr. Marty stole half of my story, but that's okay. So there's three special things about today. Now, I wonder if you can tell me the very first, number one, special thing about today. No audience participation. Right, yes, it is the Sabbath. God created in 6 days, God created the heaven, the earth, the sea, and all that in them is, and rested on the seventh day and hallowed it. Amen. So because of that, we have this day that he gave us so that we can enjoy all the beautiful things that he's created for us, right? And we can worship here together and sing praises. We can pray and read the Bible together, and that's a wonderful thing. Now, the number two special thing about today is what? The number two special thing about today. What's the date today?
November 1.
Right, well, it's a holiday, okay? Veterans Day, right. So I don't know, maybe you weren't in here when Mr. Marty was up there going on and on about it, taking the story.
You want my notes?
No, I've been working on it all week. In 1918, all the countries who were fighting in World War I got together, and on the 11th day of the 11th month at 11 o'clock in the morning, they signed the armistice, which is like a peace treaty. So that ended World War I. But they wanted to remember the veterans, people who served in that army, in the military then. And so the next year, they had a special day, and they called it Armistice Day, or Remembrance Day. And then in 1938, I think, they changed, it became a national holiday. And because of our veterans who served in the military back then, and all through the years, and my dad was one, my brothers, we have the freedom that we have to worship here today in our church and sing songs together and pray and read our Bibles together. We have that freedom because so many people served in these military, the different military groups, and because of that, we have that freedom. So we thank you. Thank you each one for your service. Now, the third very special thing is today. You know what it is? It's a very special day, no? Yeah. Okay, so on November 11th in 1917, my dad was born. And how many years is that? 100 years ago. Oh, I can't hardly say that. 100 years ago, my dad was born. Can you imagine all the things that he saw over the years? He's not here today, but he can't get around very much anymore. But when he was very young, he was very strong. And he had broad shoulders. And I have some pictures here of my dad when he was very young and very handsome. And he could do all of these neat tricks. He could stand on his hands. He could walk all over the place on his hands. He could stand on his head with no hands. He could stand on this. He could walk on his hands. He could do all of this stuff. And he taught us to do a lot of it. I could never stand on my hands, though. He taught a lot of it. But he could do all of these things because he was so strong. And I remember when I was a little girl, we lived in Michigan, and the winters were so cold. I couldn't wait for summer to get here because we could go swimming. That was my most favorite thing to do then, and it still is my most favorite thing, the water. So finally the day would come, the snow and the ice would melt, and we would all pile into my dad's jalopy, which is his old car, and we would go to Davis Lake. And we would have so much fun in the lake. And sometimes my dad would say to me, "Hold on to my shoulders." And so I would stand up. Okay, so this is your my dad. Okay, so I would hold on to my dad's shoulders like this.
Like this.
I'd hold on to my dad's big, strong shoulders, and he would go up and sink down into the water. Gliding out into the lake, you would be doing a breaststroke like this.
That one?
Not the real rowdy one, just a nice, gentle breaststroke. And you would just go gliding out into the lake, my little body floating on the water behind. And off we would go out into the water, around the lake, just quiet, just gentle, all the way back to the shore. And that's such a special memory for me. And the other day I was going through some songs that I do, and I found this song. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. Raise me up to all that I can be. Mm-hmm. Now my dad is not strong anymore. He doesn't have big strong shoulders anymore. He's very weak. He can hardly get around. But my father in heaven, on the other hand, has strong shoulders. And he will never grow old and he will never grow weak. And he's always there for us. No matter what we're going through. And we all have mountains, even you. You have mountains, and you have stormy seas. And our Father in heaven is there to lift us up and put us on his shoulders and help us through those difficult times. And that's what I want you to remember today, okay? And, I have a Bible text. This is one of my favorite Bible texts. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. That's Isaiah 41:10. So we get our strength from Jesus. And remember, there's nothing that you can ever say or do that's going to make him love you any more or any less. He just loves you. right.